merely studied theology, but had read the philosophers as well, and had dabbled with botany and alchemy on the side. He had a rather high opinion of his own critical faculties. To be sure, he would never go so far as some, who questioned the miracles, the oracles, the very truth of Holy Scripture, even though the biblical texts could not, strictly speaking, be explained by reason alone, indeed often directly contradicted it. He preferred not to meddle with such problems. They were too discomforting for him, and would only land him in the most agonizing insecurity and disquiet. Whereas to make use of one's reason, one truly needed both security and quiet. What he most vigorously did combat, however, were the superstitious notions of the simple folk. Witches and fortune-telling cards, the wearing of amulets, the evil eye, exorcisms, hocus pocus at full moon, and all the other acts they performed. It was really quite depressing to see how such heathenish customs had still not been uprooted a good 1,000 years after the firm establishment of the Christian religion. And most instances of so-called satanic possession or pacts with the devil proved on closer inspection to be superstitious mummery. Of course, to deny the existence of Satan himself, to doubt his power, Terrier could not go so far as that. Ecclesiastical bodies other than one small were assigned the task of deciding about such matters touching the very foundations of theology. But, on the other hand, it was clear as day that when a simple soul like that wet nurse maintained that she had spotted a devilish spirit, the devil himself could not possibly have a hand in it. The very fact that she thought she had spotted him was certain proof that there was nothing devilish to be found, for the devil would certainly never be stupid enough to let himself be unmasked by the wet nurse Jeanne Boussy. And with her nose, no less. With the primitive organ of smell, the basest of the senses, as if hell smelled of sulphur and paradise of incense and myrrh. The worst sort of superstition, straight out of the darkest days of paganism, when people still lived like beasts, possessing no keenness of the eye, incapable of distinguishing colours, but presuming to be able to smell blood, to sense the difference between friend and foe, to be smelled out by cannibal giants and werewolves and the Furies, all the while offering their ghastly gods stinking, smoking, burnt sacrifices. How repulsive. The fool sees with his nose rather than his eyes, they say, and apparently the light of God-given reason would have to shine yet another 1,000 years.
Calling to child, innocent creature, lying in your basket, lumbering away with no notion of the ugly suspicion raised against you. That impudent woman, scared to claim, don't smell the way human children are supposed to. Well, what do we have to say to that? And the last of that was something that was made, taking an infant child to the finger, and looking from time to time, and expressing his thought out of gentle, soothing effect, and not thinking. You're only supposed to see, come along.
I can't say, and I 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 say, and